Welcome to Physics Intuitively, the n-dimensional universe and how we see it. To quantify the measurable universe, we use the concept of dimensions. To develop an intuition about this concept, we need to first picturize it. Through our experience, we have found some physical quantities that are common for all the objects in the universe we see, and we have attributed all these physical quantities with dimensions. For example, mass is a measure of amount of inertia felt by the object. Since the inertia is affected only by the change in mass, we can say that it is unidimensional, or it has only one dimension of measurement. Now, consider volume. Volume is the amount of space occupied by any physical object. From our intuition, we know that volume is measured using three factors. So, we can say that it has three dimensions. Hence, we can conclude that dimension is a factor whose measure defines the particular physical quantity. The way we picturize the space around us has been continuously evolving. To understand this, let us start with Goldie. Goldie is a fish living in a jar in John's house. It can move in the AA' direction and the BB' direction, but the idea of moving out of the jar is alien to Goldie. Hence, we can say that Goldie perceives space around it to be two-dimensional. Similarly, consider Ante, who is climbing a hill following its natural curve. For us, it might appear that Ante is moving along a two-dimensional curve, moving forward and moving up. But Ante itself perceives its motion to be one-dimensional, that is, along the curve of the hill. We use the same concept of Ante for GPS, or the global positioning system, in which we have attributed each point on Earth with two dimensions, namely latitude and longitude, although the Earth is a three-dimensional object. Similarly, consider John. He can travel east, west, north, or south. He may even travel up and down. Hence, we can say that John perceives the space around him to be three-dimensional, or he needs three coordinates to specify his position in the space and his motion through it. This idea of space changed in the 20th century. After several experiments such as Michelson-Morley experiment and the development of the groundbreaking theory of relativity, our intuition was molded to perceive that time is a variable. After this idea of time was well established, we could perceive many more things such as the time for a person standing on Earth is different from the time for a person on the moon, and that the time for a person standing still is different from the time for a person moving in a car, which is again different from the time for a person flying in a plane. We now know that time and space are intertwined to create a four-dimensional space-time fabric which forms our universe. Then came the string theory. The string theory predicts a staggering 1 plus 9 dimensional space-time, which we are unable to comprehend with our current level of intuition, as we have no experience in perceiving these dimensions. While we are busy laughing at Goldie and Ante for their inability to perceive the dimensions in front of them, there might be some extraterrestrial beings watching us and laughing at us for our ignorance and inability to perceive the unexplored dimensions predicted by the string theory. At our current level of intuition, we may perceive only the four dimensions, but this only opens new doors to find the dimensions which are all around us and yet lay imperceptible, disguised under the cloak of human ignorance. Good luck imagining the fifth dimension. If we help in developing your intuition, please do like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thank you.